Hi, this is Brett Hodson. I'm going to do a quick overview on Sage field operations with Sage 100 Contractor, how you can give your employees out in the field the ability to enter labor and equipment time and submit it to the office very easily. Let's get started. So I'm going to call up Sage 100 Contractor. Let's go ahead and open up Sage field operations. What you're seeing right here is a dispatch screen that I can have jobs listed over here or projects and groups of employees or crews up the top. So I have a crew called my grade A tech for construction, but you can have different types of groups. Maybe they're organized by geography or Brett's crew, Reed's crew, so on. So in this case, I have this one right here with these crew members, and you can see that I have all of these folks working at the Trap and Motel today. Let's say I wanted to schedule something for Ron. Let's say I want him to go out and do rough framing. I could go ahead and just highlight that, put it on Ron's schedule for today, and then I could just drag it across to occupy the day. You can see right up here, we can also show it by the week or by the month. So you can quickly change the time scale and look at things in different ways. So if I was planning on being out there all week, I could just drag that across and that would schedule myself for the entire week. So with this dispatch, you can see I can also have vendors that I'm expecting. So I'm expecting Castillo Fence today at 12:30, and I'm going to need to use the cat loader all day at the site. So let's switch gears now and let's bring up what it would look like on my phone out in the field. So here you can see I have my phone up and you can see I have something here called assignments. Basically, this is going to be what I'm working on all week. You'll see a daily hourly total. And at the end of the week, when I submit my payroll, I'm going to see a total down here at the bottom. So let's go ahead and we're out there working on job 186 today. So I'm going to go ahead and pull it up. And now you can see these are all the different things that I can do with Sage Field Operations from my phone. I can log notes about this job. I can create or view purchase orders, work orders, field reports, RFPs, change orders, RFIs, reports, and any file attachments. So attachments that are attached back at the office, I can see them here, as well as I can take photos and submit them, and then back in the office, folks can see that too. So if I come right up here to assignments, I can say, I want to go ahead and have work start for the day today. So we have two ways we can record time. We can record start, stop, or clock in, clock out. Some people like to use that terminology. And you can see right here, I can take a break for lunch. I can switch to different cost code and so forth quite easily. You'll see here, I mentioned earlier, purchase orders. So I could look at purchase orders that have been issued for this job. You can either give people out in the field the ability to create purchase orders or simply just view ones that are there. The main thing with the example today is I'm going to pull up a field report. So let's go ahead and fill out a field report for this job. So I'm going to click Generate Field Report. And what you're going to see is the system will pull the current weather. So it's mostly cloudy, 62 degrees. While I pull this up, you can see again my assignments. So I can do my clock in, clock out, as well as the second way that you can record labor is you can just simply type the labor in. So if I wanted to record labor by saying that we're doing slab prep today, it's regular time, and it's Brett, Chris Allen, and Ryan Adams, I can select all those individuals and say that we were out there working on that for 4 hours today. I could put some notes in, easy work today. And I could save that. Okay. So we've entered in a little bit of time. These other items are completely optional. For instance, we could log some notes and we could say, job site was muddy when we arrived today. By the end of the day, it had dried out. So instead of typing, I can just talk. And then down at the bottom, you can see we have some different items here. Maybe we had a meeting today. Maybe it was a safety meeting. And we had a COVID protocol discussion. And all crew were present. And Jimmy slept during the discussion. So we'll talk to him later in the week about that. All right. So we've entered a little bit of labor. We recorded a safety meeting. You'll see down here we have equipment. So if I happen to be a contractor that has equipment that I'm using, I'm going to say we used the loader. We moved some dirt. And that was, let's put that under excavation. We move stuff around for 4 hours. Save it. All right. And down at the bottom of the screen where it says attachments, what we can do here is we can take photos. So I'm going to go ahead and take a photo. So this is, we'll say it's before. And we're going to say that's an image. And let's go ahead and take a photo. So I'm going to take a photo of this nice baseball right here, courtesy of Sage. And I'm going to click Add Attachment. And you'll notice there's a little button down here at the bottom that says New Sketch. What is that? Well, built into Sage Field Operations is a nice little sketch tool, and you can use this to draw diagrams. But one real nice item is that we can take a photo and overlay it within the sketch tool. So, very nice way to miscellaneous wet area of the site. But you could use this, maybe you wanted to, you found a leak or some sort of defect, you want to take a picture of it and you want to email it to back to the office. Very easy to do. And so we've entered in a little bit of labor time. We entered some equipment time. We took a photo. Let's say I want to get a signature from the site rep for the owner. But before I do that, you'll notice here we have a form set up. This would be a form that we built within the tool. It's a nice little form tool that's part of Sage Field Operations. You can use this to capture miscellaneous information like a safety issue or some sort of checklist, that sort of thing. So let's just go back to the field report now. And I'm just going to generate the daily field report. And I'm going to turn my phone sideways to make this a little bit bigger. So there's the note, job site was muddy. We have some labor time. We had a safety talk, we moved some dirt, and that's it. So we want to get a signature from the customer, signature from the project manager, and we're through. Now, if we wanted to, we could also attach photos, that sort of thing. Now I'm done. And I could move on to the next thing in my list. So we've filled out a daily field report. Let's go back to the office now and open up Sage 100. So I'm going to go to daily field reports. And what you're going to see here is the Williams job. There's the time that we entered. Easy work today. 4 hours for these three people. We had some time with some equipment. And if I look right up here, you'll notice that there's some notes in here. Job site was Monday when we arrived today. And there's also file attachments. So I can see daily field report. There's a copy of that with the signatures. And there's also the sketch. So there's the sketch we did. So all of that information made it back to the office faster than email, really straightforward. From here, if I was using Sage 100 Contractor Payroll, the next step in the process would be daily payroll entry. And we can pull that equipment and labor time directly in here. So real straightforward, real easy. Thanks very much for attending.